Dear students, welcome to the online lecture series of environmental science. As we are discussing about the environmental issues, and in the environmental issues we are discussing about air pollution, and in the previous lectures you must have watched discussed about different types of pollutants. Today we will try to discuss about air pollution. What is air pollution and what are the source of air pollution? But before discussing about the causes of air pollution, we will try to explain you what is air pollution. As already discussed many a times, the presence of any pollutant, as we already defined a pollutant as well. So we are going to explain the presence of pollutants in such concentration for such duration. These are the two main things you are supposed to kept in mind. This amount should be such in high concentration, and it must be remain in the atmosphere for a longer duration of time, and its concentration must be very high. The presence of pollutants in such concentration for such duration, which may cause liable to cause injuries, harmful effects on human being, living organisms and other properties as well. So we can define the air pollution. The presence of any substance in such concentration and for such duration, which is liable to be or render harmful effects on the plants, animals, microorganisms, human beings, including the property, then we can define these are air pollution. But where the actual consequence we see, then no doubt we put all the pollutants in the form of gaseous pollutant or in the form of particulate pollutants directly into the atmosphere. So before discussing air pollution, we must have a fair idea about the atmosphere. What is atmosphere actually? Atmosphere is an envelope. For example, this is the Earth. Globe is there, Earth is there, and Earth is surrounded by, from all sides, surrounded by an envelope of gas, which we call atmosphere. The atmosphere is none but the mixture of gases surrounding from all sides of Earth. And atmosphere have been divided into different layers on the basis of change or temperature gradient, change in temperature, and on the basis of composition. So we will try to discuss about the structure of atmosphere. If we move from the surface of the Earth above, the very nearest atmospheric layer is troposphere, which is extended up to 16 kilometer. Means if we move from the surface of the Earth in a vertical direction above, then we experience a particular characteristics of layer which we call as troposphere. And the troposphere is characterized by presence of oxygen gases, water vapors and other meteorological phenomena or weather phenomena occur in this very particular layer. Then if we move from 16 km above up to 49 km, then we call this a stratosphere. Means if we are extending from 16 km to 49 km, this very zone, this very region is called as stratosphere. And the characteristics of the stratosphere is the presence of maximum amount of ozone is there. Then we move on to the next valley layer, which is known as mesosphere. Mesosphere is above the stratosphere. As already described, we either divided the atmospheric layers on the basis of temperature variation or the temperature gradient, or on the basis of the presence of gases. And as we move from one layer to another layer, the presence of gases in these very layers differ from one layer to another layer. That's why we have divided the atmospheric layers into the mesosphere, thermosphere, or exosphere. But as far as the pollution is concerned, as we are in direct contact with the tropospheric layer, so after releasing the pollutants, be it primary pollutant, secondary pollutant, or any other type of pollutant, it is directly released into the troposphere. So we will discuss what are the pollutants, what are the sources of pollutants which we release into our atmosphere, into our air, and that's our atmosphere as we discussed here. So what are the pollutants actually? Sources of pollutants. If we look about the air pollution, two different sources of air pollution are, this is the stationary source. Stationary source of pollutants are those pollutants or a source of pollution which remains fixed in a particular location or a particular point. For example, we have industries, we have factories. We can easily identify a point source of pollutant coming out from any particular point source. And stationary source are the source which remain fixed at a particular point. And stationary source can be point source and area source. As already discussed, point source are the source of which can easily be identified. With factories, automobiles, incineration if taken anywhere. Then second source is area source of pollution. Area source of air pollution means all those source of pollution about which we can have the idea of the source of pollution from a particular area, but we don't know exactly what are the actual source of contribution of pollutants in that particular area. And the area source may be domestic heating, cooking, and city traffic may also be included in area source. City traffic, open burning or open incineration means point source of pollution are those source of pollution which we can easily identify, but in case of area source of pollution, we can have an idea of the source of pollution, that the area is the source of pollution, but we cannot exactly determine which is the actual cause of the air pollution of the particular area. That's why we call this as area source of pollution. Then next is mobile source of pollution. Mobile source of pollution can also be divided into line source and area source. What are line source? Line source means all the sources of pollution, especially air pollution, which we are experiencing or which we are getting from any particular transportation sector, especially the highways, highway traffic, aviation sector is there, railway sector is there, and so many other sources which are included in transportation sector. And next is area source of pollution. Area source of pollution means all those source of pollution which is coming out from a particular such areas. Say for example, transportation sector has already discussed it. Bus stand we can include in such area source of pollution. Then next very source of pollution may be based on source of pollution. It may be a natural source of pollution and man-made source of pollution. As already discussed, natural source of pollution are all those source of pollution which is directly contributing by nature without any intervention or interference of human beings. For example, if we include the natural source of pollutants, say a volcanic eruption, dust coming out due to origin of wind, pollen grains, forest fire is there, methane from marshy areas. Means these are the source of pollutants which is coming out from nature without any intervention of human beings. These may include the volcanic eruption and dust coming out from the blow of wind, pollen grains and forest fires, and the methane coming out from the marshy areas. These are included in the natural air pollutants, but we should keep in mind that pollutants coming out from the natural source are not very disastrous, because nature has got a potential to remedy itself, remedy the pollutants coming out from the natural source. But the concern is very much the pollutants released or emitted by the activities of human being or anthropogenic activities, because we never provide a time for nature to get remedy within a shortest period of time, because we are releasing the pollutant in such a high amount that nature cannot replenish or restore, get it back to its original state. That's why the source of anthropogenic or man-made source of pollution is very much a concern. Then the source of pollution may be a major source of pollutants. It may be a primary source of pollutant and it may be a secondary source of pollutants. As already discussed, what are the primary source and what are the secondary source of pollutants? If you have attended if you have watched the previous lectures, then you must know what are the primary and secondary pollutants. And primary pollutant can also be divided into gaseous pollutant or particulate pollutant. And we will discuss what are the gaseous pollutant. Gaseous pollutants we may include oxides of nitrogen, oxides of sulfur, hydrocarbon is there, carbon monoxide is there, or carbon oxide is there, carbon dioxide is there. Then hydrocarbons is already included. Aldehydes are there. Similarly, acrolein and formaldehyde. These are the source of air pollution, especially coming out from a particular source. But these are all gaseous pollutant in nature. Means these are all gaseous pollutant. Then next pollutant, we include the particulate pollutant. particulate pollutant, as already mentioned here. Particulate pollutant means all those pollutant which are other than gaseous pollutant. It may include aerosols, it may include smoke, it may include dust particles, it may include smoke, it may include fumes and so many other pollutants. It may also be in liquid form as mist, fog or smoke. For example, if we include the particulate pollutant, it may include aerosols, number one, particulate or particles, or we can say dust particles is there, then soot is there, smoke is there, fumes coming out from anthropogenic source, and so many other particulate pollutants coming from different source. But the particulate pollutants also includes the liquid substances, which may include mist, fog or smoke. Liquid in nature means particulate pollutants are the pollutants which may include either in liquid form or in solid form. All are included in particulate pollutants, and in case of liquid pollutants we may include mist, fog or smoke, and in case of particulate particles we may include aerosols, particles, soot, smoke, fumes, etc., etc. Then we will discuss the secondary air pollutants. As already discussed in the previous lecture, secondary pollutants are the pollutants which actually coming out from the industries as primary pollutant, but after reacting either with the primary pollutant or with the natural constituents of atmosphere available in the atmosphere, get react with such atmospheric constituents, then gets converted into a secondary pollutant. May include all peroxyacetyl nitrate and H2SO4, sulfuric acid is there, nitric acid is there, ozone is there. These are the pollutants which we consider as secondary source of pollutants. Hope you got understand the source of air pollution. In the next lecture, we will discuss the cause of air pollution. Till then, stay home, stay safe, best of luck.